for the latest gist on life on the Fab Lane. Get ready to get your fill. This is NX Daily Top 5 Lifestyle. Follow us on our social media platforms for the following stories and more. At number 5, Femi Otedola takes over Sadiq Daba's medical bills. Femi Otedola has promised to take care of the medical bills of ailing veteran actor Sadiq Daba. Otedola disclosed this in a recent statement. Daba traveled to the United Kingdom in 2017 for the treatment of leukemia and prostate cancer. He returned to Nigeria a few weeks after with reports that his situation was not as bad as feared. The cockcrow at Dawn Star was recently admitted at the Lagos University Teaching Hospital for what those close to him said was chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Otedola's statement reads, and I quote, "I heard about Mr. Sadiq Daba's health condition when it was brought to my attention through an online news story I read 2 days ago. I was saddened to hear that he had taken ill again after overcoming his challenges from prostate cancer just 2 years ago. From the news report, I gathered that he was rushed to the emergency unit of the Lagos University Teaching Hospital after being diagnosed with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, COPD. I must say that even though I don't know Mr. Daba personally, he is a face I'm familiar with through the old TV drama production, Cockcrow at Dawn, which I used to watch while growing up. I was moved by a sense of nostalgia and concern when I read about his medical situation recently and decided to take over his medical bills. He has been visited and arrangements are being made to support him. In other climes, the likes of Sadiq Daba and other such actors who more or less paved way for the entertainment industry and Nollywood industry in Nigeria, which is touted as the third largest movie industry in the world, would be celebrated as icons and due recognition will be accorded to them. For me, taking care of Sadiq's medical expenses is my little way of showing appreciation and gratitude for the good memories he created for me and others in the past." End of quote. At number 4, Young Dro arrested for violent attack. Law enforcement sources say Young Dro was arrested for allegedly throwing a plate of banana pudding at his girlfriend during an argument at their Atlanta area home. Report says the two had been arguing over money, but things got heated and the food started flying with both sides launching whatever delicious items they could find at each other. Cops were called to the scene, despite the fact his girlfriend made it clear she didn't want to press charges. They arrested Dro anyway. He's now facing 2 counts of misdemeanor, battery, and family violence. He's still in jail too, according to law enforcement sources, because he's also being held on a child support contempt order. The legal doc says he owes almost $41,000 in child support and needs to pay $10,000 to be released from custody. Young Dro sources say the child support case involves another baby mama, not his current girlfriend, who he had the pudding spat with, and the rapper claims he's all paid up, so it's a clerical error. Counting off to number 3, Kamala Harris' California fundraiser crashed. Kamala Harris seems to have Hollywood squarely in her corner as she continues her campaign for putos, and she's got manager to the star Scooter Baron to thank for it. The California senator attended a fundraiser that Scooter threw for her on Saturday, which took place at his home in Los Angeles. Some very famous faces dropped by as well, including Ariana Grande, Katy Perry, and Demi Lovato, two of them who are Scooter's clients. It was an RSVP event and was slugged as a fireside chat with the presidential hopeful. He also posted pics of him, Ari, and Demi and called them fam. Things got more interesting beyond the celebs just being there. Scooter's feud with Taylor Swift is coming into the picture, and him hosting Kamala appears to have pissed off tons of her fans, with lots of Swifties calling Kamala and co sellouts, and some even vowing not to vote for her come primaries. Scooter now owns the master recording to Taylor's old catalog of music, which she lashed out at him over last month. Interestingly, Taylor seems to have been pretty down with Senator Harris in the past, retweeting her here and there. But she's been even more vocal supporter of one of Kamala's Democratic rivals, Cory Booker. Taylor shouted him out when he backed the Equality Act in June. Stepping down to number 2, Cardi B tattoos Offset on her upper thigh.
Do anything for clout, anything. Do anything for clout, anything. They do anything for clout, do anything for clout. They do anything for clout.
Cardi B's got Offset under her leg and she's proudly showed it off with a newly revealed tattoo while chatting with her hubby. Offset posted a very up close and personal snapshot of what appears to be a FaceTime convo he was having with Cardi B, in which she hoisted up her leg and showed him a tat bearing his name on the backside of her thigh. He captioned his post in quote, "Can't wait to get home," end of quote, throwing in a bunch of tongue emojis for good measure. Offset also put a tongue out emoji over his mug. What's interesting about the tat is that it appears appears to have flown under the radar until now. We already knew Cardi was covered in ink. She's got upwards of 8 documented tattoos, but it's pretty sweet she's got her husband etched in too, considering their ups and downs. Even more cool is the fact that Offset also has himself a Cardi tat on his neck, under a pic of Buttercup from the Powerpuff Girls. It made its debut early last year, and Cardi B herself sure seemed to like it in a video she posted of a body art. Looks like Cardi returned the favor between them and now. Finally, at number 1, ASAP Rocky won't release race issue in Swedish assault case. Rocky's race is not an issue in his arrest or detention. There's certainly plenty of smoke as reported. Jeezy and white rapper was arrested in Sweden for assault and cocaine possession. Yet he only spent a day and a half in jail, pled guilty and coughed up $9,000, and he was on his merry way. ASAP has been in jail going on 3 weeks and he hasn't even been charged. What happened? It would only be for aggravated assault, an assault that was provoked by the alleged victim. ASAP sources say he has made it clear to all in contact with him. He doesn't think he's being held because he's black. That's consistently been his story. Here's the reality. If ASAP or his team dared suggest he's being held because he's a black rapper, there would be hell to pay with the prosecutor and probably the judge as well. They've been speaking with Swedish embassy and other officials and they're all adamant that they do not discriminate. If foreigners suggested otherwise in court, sources say it will be a disaster. Sources said ASAP will be charged and will then face 6 years in prison. The best defense they got is provocation by the alleged victim. One thing's clear by now. All the work the State Department and President have done trying to lobby Swedish officials hasn't worked. In fact, it may have been counterproductive because prosecutors may not like what they consider intermeddling and the Prime Minister is siding with them. And that's it for today on NX Daily Top 5 Lifestyle. More juicy gist coming your way next time. Don't forget you can watch this and more on our social media platforms. On Facebook and Instagram, it's at NYGZ Extreme. Tweet at us at NYGZ TV and you can visit our website at www.nygz.tv.